We are here today outside the Excel Center in London, where Bett 2015 education event is being held to protest Hewlett Packard's inclusion in this event and the invitation for its Vice President for Worldwide Education, Gus Schmedien, to speak at the event. Most people think of Hewlett Packard as an innocent office supplies and printer company, but the reality is far darker. Hewlett Packard is one of the top arms companies in the US with arms sales worth $3 billion in 2011. The Stockholm International Peace Research Institute has done the research, and when they say arms sales, they define that as goods and services designed specifically for military purpose and does not include general purpose equipment like office equipment. They also state that the figure may be an underestimated as it doesn't include classified contracts that Hewlett Packard might be involved in. Bett 2015 is meant to be an education, a schools show. Why has a leading arms dealer been invited to speak here? In Hewlett Packard's own words, Israel is one of the few countries where Hewlett Packard has a massive presence. In the past decade, Hewlett Packard has invested over $6 billion in the acquisition of Israeli companies, including the establishment of production plants. Hewlett Packard is the second largest investor in Israeli IT. Hewlett Packard implements and manages the server farm for the entire Israeli Army and Ministry of Defense. Israel's largest server tender worth $140 billion. Those Hewlett Packard servers form the IT backbone of the entire Israeli war machine, which has been found guilty of war crimes and possible crimes against humanity by the United Nations Human Rights Council. Last summer, Israeli missiles targeted 118 schools in Gaza, including 65 United Nations schools, resulting in the slaughter of 521 children. And this is not a new phenomenon. For the past 14 years, every 60 hours, Israel kills one Palestinian child. Hewlett Packard makes such slaughter possible with the strategic support of Israel's killing machine. We want to ask Hewlett Packard's Vice President for Education, Gus Schmedien, what of the children in Palestine? Your technology and services are killing Palestinian children. How on earth does that fit with your claim of inspiring children to learn through technology? Every 60 hours, you help kill one more child. Imagine, from the moment the doors open for Bett 2015 to when they close on Saturday, more than one more Palestinian child will have been killed. Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Hewlett Packard has been equipping the Israeli military since 2006, when it was contracted to provide the IT infrastructure for the Israeli Navy and a pilot for implementing across the entire army, helping the Navy execute its illegal blockade of Gaza, which also began in 2006. In 2009, Hewlett Packard was contracted to supply all computer equipment to the entire Israeli military. Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Last year, Israel abducted 1,266 Palestinian children. That's one child taken from their parents every 7 hours. 40% of the 600 that were taken from Jerusalem alone was sexually abused by Israeli soldiers during arrest or interrogation. During interrogation, 75% of Palestinian children detained by Israel are physically tortured. Hewlett Packard keeps those torture dens and dungeons where Palestinian children are caged and abused operational by the IT infrastructure it provides to the Israeli prison service. Hewlett Packard also provides Israeli prisons and interrogation centers the systems and servers needed to keep them operational. These dungeons and torture dens are where Palestinian children as young as 12 years old are brutally tortured and caged in 1 meter by 3 meter dark holes in the ground for months without charge or trial. We want to ask Hewlett Packard's Vice President for Education, Gus Schmedien, do you feel any shame in coming to speak at a children's education event whilst at the same time your company is facilitating the torture of children in Palestine? Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Today, there are over 6,000 political Palestinian prisoners, including women and children, many caged without a charge or trial. 72 Palestinians have been tortured to death in Israeli prisons since 1967. The latest being a father of 5 young children, Raed Abdel Salam Al-Jawari, who died following interrogation at Eshel prison on the 9th of September 2014. He had been arrested over a simple car accident involving an illegal Israeli settler. The Israeli prison service said he had committed suicide by hanging himself in his cell, but the autopsy revealed he had been savagely tortured with repeated blows to the head and face, causing brain hemorrhage. His neck showed no signs of hanging. Hewlett Packard keeps these hellholes operational with its IT infrastructure, services, and servers. Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Hewlett Packard has also developed Israel's prisoners management system and intelligence subsystems, which helps the occupation keep illegal records on Palestinians it has abducted and their families. Female family members have been threatened with rape in order to coerce confessions from children accused of stone throwing. Hewlett Packard is complicit in all these crimes. Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Hewlett Packard also developed and maintained the Basel system, a biometric access control system used by Israel at illegal checkpoints deep inside occupied territory to restrict and control Palestinian freedom of movement in their own land. It forms part of the separation wall apparatus declared illegal by the International Court of Justice in 2004. Shame on you, Hewlett Packard!
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 Many of us attending this education show will be parents and teachers. We all have a responsibility and choices to make. The clearest message we can send Hewlett Packard that we don't approve of their complicity in the murder and torture of children in Palestine is by boycotting their products and letting them know why. As you go in, please visit the Hewlett Packard stand and tell them you do not wish to support the killing and torture of children, including Palestinian children, and will be boycotting their products until they stop their complicity with Israel's war crimes. Thank you. Boycott Israel!
Boycott Israel!
Boycott Hewlett Packard!
Boycott Hewlett Packard!
Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!